Hello and welcome back to Banner Saga. Let's talk about Bubbles first. You're back. So, what was that all about? What did the king have to say? Something about putting aside our differences. And he wants me to try and wring an antidote out of Ruga. Since Mainwall is lying, everyone's been let into the city under his protection. I wonder if I would change my mind like that if I knew the end was near. Is it not? Shut up, you know what I mean. So how are you feeling about all of this? All of this? Care to narrow it down? She smiles politely, waiting for a question. What should we do about Ruga? Gods, I wish he just didn't exist. You know he's not going to just hand over a cure, not without a high price anyway. He's gambling with people's lives for his own benefit. Why do people like him? They always seem to prosper. Well, rule don't come to those who have a deep desire to rule. You mean madmen? You spend so much time and effort trying to do the right thing, and here comes Ruga. He may as well be stabbing children as he goes and people love him for it. But anyway, what can we do? Press and beating soon seem to work. The man can take a punch, I'll give him that. Can't kill him yet either, for Mainol's sake. What does he even want? The throne? What's the point of ruling Aberrant for a couple of days before the darkness takes him back? I'm sick of thinking about Ruga. Let's change the subject. She smiles politely, waiting for your question. What's your deal with the Horseborn, anyway? My deal? What do you mean? Oh, you're going to pretend later. There's nothing up with you. I heard you giggle the first time you saw one. I don't giggle. Okay, look, I just don't repeat this. Promise? Promise. When I was a girl, I remember my father showing me pictures of horses. They looked amazing. I wanted one so bad. Then he told me they were all killed, totally wiped out. Do you know the story? Legend says the Loom Mother made horses, and another god created the Horseborn from them. But there was a time when both Horseborn and horses existed. They would see people use horses for farming and carrying goods, and wouldn't know how to react. Was it slavery? Were horses like children to them, or some living reminder that they're just dumb beasts? You could ask the same about Varl. Come on, it's not the same. They're all pretty different from yokes. No debate how the Horseborn were made. Anyway, rather than let anyone own horses, the stories say the Horseborn went crazy and slaughtered them all. Then they fought the humans a bit, but eventually retreated herself. They say the Horseborn felt such shame about the massacre, they just never returned. Who knows what the truth really is? Up till the moment I saw one, I was never even sure the Horseborn really existed. But they're real. They're really real. And they're so beautiful. And they're causing us all kinds of problems. Olive's beaming face and white green deflates. Tell me about it. She smiles politely, waiting for a question. What would you do in Mainwall's position? That's a tough one. You know me, I want everyone to live, maybe even not hate each other. Ruga's men are bastards, but I don't think they deserve to die. And we're going to have to make amends with the war. They're not happy about how things played out, but I'm not the king, so I guess there's not much else to say about it. She smiles politely, waiting for a question. You better get back to camp. Yeah, I suppose we should. How are you holding up? Will you ever get tired of doing the right thing? What choice do we have? Leave? Go south? See what happens. I'm just thinking out loud. Some people are talking about ships. After what we saw in Fiskvik, the serpent's blood was eating all the boats, and it killed everything living in the sea. I know it's not a real option. Now we've got to rely on each other. Just remember, you've always got a shoulder here. Don't try to carry this all on your own. Petrus. Oh, market. Let's visit the market. Do we have no food? Okay, there's no food. Oh, that's cute. But we don't have people. Oh, let's see. People will promote me. Yes, I know. I played the game. Thank you very much. And let's bring this. Can you give yourself up? Interesting. Now you are level 10. Yep. I'll give you one of those. Do you mind this? This called purple. Thank. Maybe this one because you get hit a lot. We have not had time for proper introductions. I didn't even know it would be necessary. Are you comfortable with the king's orders? It's no matter of a comfort. I was given with such warnings as you were. That is to say, none. But if these are the king's orders, I will follow them. Is there anything you wish to know? Petra stands at attention, waiting for your response. How did you become the guard captain in Aberrang? He looks uncomfortable and unaccustomed to looking at himself. I won't bore you with the details. I was an orphan. When I was young and impetuous, I overthrew the vicious bastards who were selling children in the slums. I didn't love killing a man. The main wolves made me an honor guard. A few years later, after an attempted coup, I became captain. You may have a guess who incited that attempted coup. Fast tries to pour. Power only means you have the luxury of putting your own needs last. Petra stands at attention, waiting for your response. What can you provide? Several hundred trained fighters, weapons and armor, and access to the king, should you need it. Several hundred fighters in a city of several hundred thousand? We're lucky for that. Look at Frostveldr or Borsgar, the wealthy by control. Any upset of balance and the wealthy families hack each other to pieces over it. Innocent people get caught in the fray. The king is trying to change that in Aberrang, but it's slow going. Tradition dies hard. And in my experience, many would just prefer to hack each other to pieces in the first place. Why did the main wolf put me in charge of an outsider? It would be above my position to assume, but in my opinion, you answered the question yourself. The king knows the other clans in Aberrang too well, I think. Schemes and secret plots flourish in a city like this, but your banner speaks for you. You better than an in-depth outsider to handle the other outsiders. So he can expect me to do as he says, and take the blame if things go wrong, too. That's one way to look at it. Aren't the wealthy families in Aberrang going to be upset about this? Without a doubt. Petra stands at attention. You probably have things to do. As you say, my men were spread thin already. I'm almost more worried about the clans than the dredge. May I offer some advice? Please do. Rely on me to understand the city. Sometimes men who come from the countryside see things as a straight path, but Aberrang is a circle. If you try to change direction, suddenly you risk being flung over a cliff. And we are dangerously close to a steep drop. I appreciate your counsel. Thank you. Of course, if you need me, I will be nearby. I guess we lost. We go again to Petrus. Petrus escorts you to your camp, which was set up while you were gone. I know King Maynolf asked you to speak with Rugat once, but after he's been ambushed us, I have been too... He's not capable of speech for the moment. It seems like you do have some history. I will bring you to speak with him as soon as possible. For now, I would suggest rest. It has been a long day for us all. Olive has been waiting for you to return. You can hear singing and laughing in the distance. Where is everyone? Celebrating! For the first time since we left Skogrim, we can just stop. You made it. Thanks to you. I don't feel dumb yet. The dredge could easily tear through that flimsy outer wall if they wanted to. And as far as I can tell, we've still got no answer to the darkness. What do you think Ivor's doing right now? Probably keeping them all from killing each other, if I know Ivor. I know you're right, but I miss him. It feels strange, this sudden call. Nothing to do but wait. You're right. I can't even walk on the roof guy yet. The guard captain went wild on him. Good! On the other hand, what if my lord dies? Between Ruga's loyalists, the horseborn, and the power struggle, the city may turn itself. The harder we try to grip this world, the faster it seems to slip from our fingers. What if we didn't think about the rest of the world? The one left? Are you suggesting? Yes, Rook, I'm very much suggesting. Then I'm very much accepting. Oh, then I guess the celebration will have to wait for us a little longer.
Darkness hasn't responded to anything I've tried so far. Damn you, Juno! How did you... I can't give up.
My friends in Arbaram and joined the spellweavers Juno and Eivind on their journey to undo the darkness and put an end to a world-eating serpent. Juno fashioned a dome of light around us and we pushed into the darkness. I expected desolation. Instead, we've passed villages that look as though melted and forests curled like fish hooks. I've had a bad feeling that these things will never again return to the way they once were, even if we succeed. With us came a band of mercenaries, the Ravens, tricked into believing the orders came from their leader. This, too, feels like disaster waiting to happen.
You need to address this now, Juno. You catch one of the ravens staring at you for the third time. The whispering between them has become worse. Not yet. Soon. The longer you control Volka's mind, the worse it will be when you drop the tricks. The ravens you brought with us are hardened mercenaries. They won't take lightly to being kidnapped. There was no time to convince them properly, and we need their plates and shields out here. What's happened out here exactly? The darkness doesn't kill, it warps. There are things hiding out here we don't want to meet. Perfect. I have a feeling they might notice this giant dome of light. I'm afraid it's necessary. It's the only thing keeping the darkness from warping us as well. I will release Volka's mind soon, when they discover their trap within the light. Just warn me before you do it. It will be hard to miss. What I've done, I know how it looks. It isn't the way I wanted things to be. Please, Ivor, put your trust in us a little longer. Just fix this. Believe me, we're trying.
The old city on the human world border looms ahead, twisted into a claw, but still strand. Now, I have to imagine the longboats bringing fish in the harbor, and the bustling of merchants hawking goods. An unexpected light from Strand's great hall calls to us from atop the hill. We'll stop briefly to investigate.
Okay, I don't want to need a book, the heck? Maybe instead walking with the apostate of the 16. Oh, it just no good. Hmm. Have some... okay. Some nice arcade. Okay. I have some points as well. That's cool, that's always good. Huh. Where did you get from? Really though, where did you get from? Okay, I'll... Here are the path available. Scrolls say the names, not of simple people, but of the legend they have become. Choose a character to bestow upon this hero. Once chosen, it can be undone, and the title will be made to this hero. Let's break order so many. Forsaken. They're hopeful, I guess. Oh, it costs me an hour. Okay. It wasn't fine, but... Oh, well. We'll stick with that. Maybe I was equipped with something. So we're ready! Just in time. Okay, I get it now. Survivors, let's clear things out. Can I move you? Yep, I can. Great. Maybe I can use the vocal spear to constrain lightning on me. Ooh, nice. Whoa, that they absorb a lot. They really absorb a lot. So, go for his armor. You, what can you do? Strength of will. Ride the lightning. For the spear set. Oh, no. Target heals for half hours first. Okay, so this is heal. Okay. Oh. Hey. Okay. You have bloody flail. Then I kinda screwed it up. But he's blocked, he can go over here. Oh. Okay. We need to keep her alive. God damn it. Do it like this. Okay, you didn't absorb, that's good. Leave the witch! fuck was so this okay. The adjacent. Should be this. Nice. I can cut sometimes. This, like this. Oh, we can use those. I already forgot. Oh, in addition we can... Okay. Bloody flame, I guess. Parasite, oh my god. No, she's done. Oh, I need to get rid of her fast. Yes, I know, I'm sorry. Wait. Sorry. Wait, is this one? Yeah. That's actually good. I ever can walk up the room, I can do this. And you wait. When the quiet comes, it feels unnatural, like being underwater. What happened to those things anyway? Asks Volka, breaking the silence. Wait, oh, the strange woman in my... I missed that. The strange woman replies.
Dredge, human, bark. It doesn't matter out here, not dead.
But their minds were gone even before we laid them to rest. The charred remains of the warped creatures bubble and fizz in the light and smell horrible. You take the conversation outside the ruined hall as you descend toward the food on the strand. An unexpected place to find visitors. The dredge will trouble and enough in strand without being warped into monsters. I wasn't sure we'd ever be unstuck from this abyss, even with our friends light. Good that you stayed put. You won't outpace the darkness on food. You travel into the wind, not away. To undo it.
Undo the darkness. How?
Naomi remember this. The woman is Valka. But you are not. How did you learn how to weave the light?
I've picked up a thing or two on my own. You learn to protect yourself when the Menders are trying to kill you.
Why? What do you mean by that?
My name is Alfrun. Do you know who you're traveling with, I wonder?
Despite our history, I came this way to see the council in Manahar. You wonder if they're amazing it found me instead. My companion has words for you as well. Alfrun motions to the towering dredge stone guard over her shoulder.
You can tell Juno is uncomfortable with this, but she remains composed as ever.
Awing, less so.
Wait, hold on. This is our enemy. Time is up.
Time itself? Then you need capable allies.
I can see it on your face. Can I trust the witch? Will the storm god kill us in our sleep? What I'm wondering is why there's so much color in the air between you and the big lady with the red shield. The glance at Volka always had swivels back and forth between her and Juno. It felt the only one drawing open. The Juno girl in your head, be ready.
Volka shadows from here.
Where are we?
She grows over an original spell.
Trapped in the dark with a treacherous witch, all these walls. I knew it, Volka.
Her words have been coming out in her mouth since we left Bolvar, the old world. Volka's pain starts spreading after itself. She screams, and you only barely manage to turn aside her spear, all of her drawn weapons. Intimidate the madness?
Who will be first?
You roar, then flinch at your ferocity, but even more so from the purple of lightning aiming behind you.
A velveteen dizziness washes over the group. Juno says, if this world is going to survive, everyone is needed.
Volka struggles against the weariness.
Volka is a flying fan about the world!
But she makes one over the rocks.
When this is all over, the ravens will get what's owed.
Count on that. Everybody shut up! You hear that?
These things are came out of nowhere. We must stand together to survive.
They only have two options.
Fine, but this conversation isn't over.
Waves. The legions of the world often attacking waves. After the first wave, you may fight or flee, defeat the boss in the final wave, and gain a powerful item. Number of player turns remaining before the opponents appears. Okay. Who's first? This guy, so she can.
She absorbed all of it?
But that just works. Get his arm first.
I don't think those are dredge.
Every transformation has over.
Whatever. Ooh, that's
who's next? That guy over there. We can get over to him, so we'll try and kill him. Wait,
what?
Throw stones. Invisible shards of empty darkness were starting to adjacent. So can I do it like this? And it absorb anyway, get them. Weaved energy, target my home, this energy. Who's next? This guy. Can you confuse him? You can't, you have to move a bit. Should be fine. Get them.
Really?
Him. You can't? Oh.
Why? Why can't you confuse him?
I'm confused.
Damn it!
She's dead. Wait, she was hit for what? Okay. I have no idea what's going on. Whirlpower absorbs. Wait. Okay, Whirlpower absorbs all strain damage and depleted. Okay. We'll have to run. Like the heroes when you're force and battle, she isn't incapacitated. Instead, she becomes a ghost in this point. As a ghost, Juno cannot attack with his ability, but she can move and she can collect the files of dark energy that are visible on her. Each form that Juno collects receives both strength and willpower. When trying to maximize Juno's form collection, each time remember that you can collect multiple tiles in sequence of drawing units more precisely. At any point, you can restore Juno to life with the strength pool she has currently by stepping onto her body. This? I can't tell what this one is. It's 2, you have 0. Okay. I don't know whether we'll be able to make it through this one. Zero. Okay. This should work. It worked. Right, you. You need to move for here, I guess. Zero. Oh well. He's down. Oh. Do you have Tempest? Battering Ram Tempest, great. Hit here, hit her, hit this dog. Here. I think I overdid it. This time, pushing this. Hey, oh, hit those two as well. So she doesn't attack. Wait. I thought Arcus can't. Wait. Interesting. Hey, can you go back to your body now? Give it. So what happens now?
A sprite. Okay, we can change. We can add some more, so I definitely wanna... Yes.
May choose to fight a more phenomenal and visible item of food to save interest. Okay, so I wanna fight, but I wanna change! Let me...
Okay, reinforcements. Thank you. Red triangle show from which side the combat the enemies will appear. Refresh your party with some roster, then assemble them out of the combat board. Okay, so... Give me him. Instead of you, I want you. You... Are you hurt? Don't think you are hurt. I'd rather have him. Wait, you don't have any items. God damn. Okay, okay, it's fine. And I forgot to move them. Yeah. So this is partly because I forgot to move them. Really? So we could hit for 4. Wait, okay. I'm kidding. Oh, there was another one. Can you do something? The raptor wounded, judge explode doing damage. Okay, wait. Not really. Well, we can move like this and try to attack him. Damn it. Zero. No, that's great. Kindle and drum fire. Let's get over here. No, I want to hit him. You have 6 more. Oh, oh, no, 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 I didn't like that. Can you confuse him, please? Can you confuse him, please? Can you confuse anyone? He's down. Nope. I keep forgetting about that. Wait, give me a second. What? Okay, it's just lag. So I don't want him to get close enough to kill. Wait, oh, she died. Wait, you still have time to slide? Yeah, you do. You don't have Tempest. Yeah. That's all the move we can do. As long as this guy says nearly all of my guys are alive, I'm fine. Go for the Tempest. Two. This guy doesn't matter anymore. I was pretty sure he's going to kill his guy. Wait, that was... Oh, so he was the boss? Okay. Hit him. Wait, where is Samuel? The wanderers of all the other ways, hidden ones, to get from place to place. Hey, mercy! I'm Kurumak. Does Juno count as casualty? No. Okay. Okay, but that's gonna be it for today because it's getting a bit long. So for now, thank you very much. Stay alive and see you soon. Bye!